Do you have a job, but your ass is always broke? Right? You couldn't budget if your life depended on it. Right? You couldn't save a dollar, even if it was stapled to your forehead. If that's you, then stay tuned, because today on Real Spit, we got a couple of money-saving techniques that can put some extra change in your pocket. Welcome to Real Spit. This is where you get hit, bam, with the Real Spit. All right, so doing what we always do here at Real Spit, we reach into the bag of Hearthstones to set the tone. What do we got? We got change. How about that? This is very appropriate because we're going to help change your mentality, your relationship with money, and put a little bit of extra change in your pocket. All right. According to 24/7 Wall Street, they say that 65% of Americans drink alcohol. Right? And out of that, in the larger cities, they spend on average, a person spends on average $512 to $1,200 a month on booze. Is that you? Right? Do you end up spending $10 to $12 per six pack and you end up doing one, two, maybe three six packs a week? If that's you, right? Or maybe your guilty pleasure is a latte at $6.63 a pop. Right? 6 days a week, maybe, let's just say. So imagine if you curtailed that a little bit and took a little bit off the table and just said, you know what, I'm not going to go there. I'm going to save at least 10 bucks a week, right? One less six pack, two less lattes, $10 a week, right? Four times a week, that's $40 that you're saving, right? Four times 12 is 480. Next thing you know, you got $500 at the end of the year staring at you in your savings, right? That's not bad, but how do you get there? How can you actually secure that money? It's called a concept called pay yourself first. So this is when you end up actually opening up a bank account just for your own personal savings. That's it. That's all that only goes there. It's an account that where only money goes in. So if you got a Wells Fargo or a Chase, open up another bank over here, maybe a Capital One, and what you're going to do is you're going to create a coupon book. And in that coupon book, you're going to write your checks out to yourself, put it in an envelope, and send it to your bank over here, right? So then you do this before you end up paying your light bill or your cell phone bill. You pay yourself first. It sends a psychological message that you are more important than any other thing that's out there. Okay, so there it is. Pay yourself first. Now imagine this is what happened to me when I was younger. I had a car note, $270 a month. When I was done paying for that car, I continued to pay myself first, $270 a month. At the end of 5 years, I had $16,200. So that's the mentality where I put myself first before any other materialistic situation, before any other bills, I paid me first. Imagine the reinforcement, the psychological reinforcement that I am of value, what that does to an individual. Now there's other things out there. There's things like Acorn, that's an app where you end up paying for something, let's say it's $1.75 and 25 cents of it goes into an account for you, right? They got Sweatcoin where you can walk around and you can earn some money by doing that. There's even a thing called Coin Seed, which is just very much just like the Acorn. Any of those things can work for you to earn a little extra money on the side. Of course, there's a whole plethora of things that are out there. But really what I wanted to drive home today is you changing your mentality around money, put yourself first, pay yourself first, and then go ahead and start saving, right? Change your mentality, reduce some of those bad habits, and convert it into cash. Thanks for listening to another episode of Real Spit. Happy earnings.